So hello all of you. Today we will be continuing with the April 2021 paper which we were doing last class. So last class we had done up to question 5. Today we'll continue with question number 6. So once again, a reminder, you move on to a fresh blank page and start every answer. Make sure your answer number is a little highlighted. Maybe you can make it bold, and if you want, you can increase the size. For increasing the size, the shortcut is Control Shift and greater than sign. For decreasing it, it's Control Shift and less than sign. For bold, it's Control plus B. Okay, so let's start. So now when you start typing, you will realize after you press enter, your bold and increased font size remains. So make sure that when you start typing, you come back to the normal font and the normal different arrangements. So the bold that you had taken, make sure to press Control B again so that it becomes unbold. Okay, so let's see. Question 6. Claims on a particular type of insurance policy follows a compound poison process with annual claim rate per policy of 0.4. Individual claim amounts are exponentially distributed with mean 120. In addition, for a given claim and independent of its size, there is a probability of 20% that an extra claim handling expense of 30 is incurred. The insurer charges an annual premium of 60 per policy. Estimate using a normal approximation the minimum number of policies to be sold so that the insurer has at least a 99% probability of making a profit. So this question, when you all will sit to solve it, it was a very, very, very good question, both from the typing point of view as well as from the practical knowledge or the concept point of view. Okay, so this is one sum which I would strongly recommend that you should practice on MS Word. Because number one, you'll be able to practice the sum also. So because while typing, it's not just your typing speed, it's also how much you can think and process while typing on MS Word. Okay, so this is a very good question for that kind of practice. So as you can see, it's an 11 mark question. Yes. So what we are going to do is, as you all can see, they have extended the number of marks for such a question, because not only do they have to provide for the advanced level of the question, but they also have to provide, because as it's so evident that a lot of typing is involved, and naturally for such questions where you have a lot of equation solving, there is a considerable amount of typing, because you have to explain all your calculations. You can't just randomly skip steps giving a reason that you're giving the exam on MS Word. So that's why there are a lot of steps that have to be written, because of which every line has one mark. Maybe if it was offline, they could have given it for half a mark some lines, but they've given it for one mark so that they can provide for the typing efforts as well. So let the individual total claim costs be denoted by X. Then X is equal to Y plus Z, where Y is the cost of the claim and Z is the claim handling expense. Expectation of X is equal to Y plus Z, which is this. So very, very, very important. Every time you use a variable, make sure you're explaining or mentioning what that variable denotes, because it might so happen even if there are some, for example, later we will see, for N policies. Now, if you randomly introduce an N in your answer script, you will think that N, anyway, we use it for denoting numbers, number of policy, number of claims, etc. So it's a very given thing that N must be number of policies. But no, you have to mention that N is policies. Okay. S is the total claim amounts. X is the individual total claim cost. Y is cost of claim and Z is claim handling expense. Every variable has to be explained. If, even if you're doing it in just 2 to 3 words, even if you're not forming sentences, it's fine. You can just write X is whatever, Y is whatever. No need to write full sentences. You can simply use words and phrases as well. Another thing, every time you meet such big questions, so all the important aspects, by the time you sit for the exam, you will know which are the aspects that carry marks and which aspects are just general working. So every aspect that carries marks, you have to make sure that after you write the formula, you must write an expanded version. Okay. So over here, you can see that expectation of Y is expectation of Z. You have to show that 120 is the expectation of Y and 0.2 into 30 is the expectation of Z, right? And only after that will you write the final value. Don't skip steps thinking that we can strictly write this. Make sure you write the expanded version for every line. Similarly, over here again, expectation of F, you have to show that it's 0.4 into 126 into 9. One thing over here to notice is, over here everywhere they have used N as a variable, they've also used an asterisk to show it's 50.4 into N or 110.31 square into N. Okay. So instead of doing this, what is also acceptable, you can just write this. It's completely fine. No need, there is no mandatory thing that you have to use the asterisk. Again, over here, everywhere you can simply, here, 9.6 into N, until and unless you are showing a proper multiplication expansion, the asterisk is not required. You can straight away write 9.6 N. Other things in this question which you can do differently is, suppose variance. Every time you write variance, it's not mandatory that you have to use VAR. No, you can just simply use a V also. Variance of X can be written like this by simply giving a V. Apart from that, for the normal variable, many of us might be more comfortable, or we are in the practice of either using phi, capital phi, as the CDF of normal distribution, or the standard normal variable Z. So over here, what we have done, usually this step, how would we write this? We would have written this as, I would have written it properly as probability Z
with z is less than this thing. I'll just copy paste this. It is less than this entire portion. Okay, that's what I would have done, because while practicing, I always use z as the standard normal variable. If you all are comfortable in this, then you can always write n 0, 1. Some of us, maybe over here, we cannot use 5 because we have a variable inside, right? So what we can do is, let's say over here, when we removed the normal variable in the next step, what you could have done is you could have written wherever you got this value from, 2.32648, you could have written phi of this is equal to 2.326348. That time you could have used phi, okay, if you all are comfortable, because here they haven't mentioned from where they got the value, but in your answer script, you might lose marks for not mentioning. And trust me, these are things that have happened at some point, that the institutes, they do tend to consider that maybe you have adopted some unfair means, or maybe you have taken the answer from somewhere. If you do not give proper referencing, every time you use the table book, make sure you mention from page XYZ of tables. Okay, make sure you always write this every time you take out a value from the table book. Okay. Right. Now, again, be sure, as you can see, properly steps are shown. Now, over here, variance of y plus variance of z. This is the formula you are writing. Make sure you are putting in the values of the formula. Okay. So, for example, variance of y is 14,400. So, you have to show that separately. You cannot simply expect the examiner to know what is variance of y or what is variance of z. You have to show and make it amply clear that 144 is the variance of z and 14,400 is the variance for y. Okay. Maybe if you want, you all can see over here, even though you have written, you have shown that variance of y is this and variance of z is this, but again, you must show an expansion or a substitution step for every formula that you're using. All right. That was number 6. Now moving on to number 7. An actuarial analyst is investigating the forces of mortality for males aged 65 and over. The analyst has studied a group of 100 male lives, all of whom were exactly 65 years old at the beginning of the study, over a 10-year period, and has estimated the following forces of mortality based on the lives observed in the study. So this table is given. Determined to 6 decimal places, the probability that a 65-year-old male is alive at age 75 using the estimated forces of mortality in the table above. So, for this, it's a very small question. It's just for 3 marks. So, what you can do, this is a question that requires a little bit of integration, and it can get a little complicated. People, students or candidates might get confused regarding the brackets especially to put in this case. Okay. So one more thing that is there in this question, again, what you can do differently. One thing in number 6, by the way, which I forgot to mention, is this x square, this y square that we are writing. Here, you must write the caret sign. You must type the caret sign, which is this sign, to show that it is a square. Usually, it's only for sigma square, sigma 2 is acceptable. But for the others, it is always advisable that you give the caret sign. Don't think that the institute said that instead of x underscore ij, we can write xij. That is a different thing. But in these cases, instead of writing x2, write x square. That is better, okay? So if you keep in that factor, it's always a better thing for you. After that, yes, number 7. So the probabilities, the life probabilities. instead of giving 10 underscore p underscore 65, you can simply write 10 p 65, 100% acceptable. Okay, 10 p 65, 1 p 65, don't have to go on giving underscores everywhere. All right, after that, what do we do? We do e to the power, and then in the power, we do a minus and integration. So here, it does get a little tricky. It does get a little complicated. So go step by step, e to the power. So first we type e. So as I have said, instead of e, we will use exponential, because then we do not have to give the power sign and make it complicated. You can simply put the function or the expression inside the bracket. So e to the power minus integration. So you can see that as I'm saying whatever I used to write, I'm going on typing it. Okay. So as I said, integration, current INTK. Okay. Integration from 0 to 1. So the limits came. Then for the function, we give a colon 0.04 dp. Then what I would suggest is they haven't given the brackets because it is just one number. So you can avoid brackets, but of course it's always better that if you give a bracket for the function being integrated as well. Okay. So suppose I give a bracket like this. Again, now what can be done? There are two things that you can do. You can either copy paste this. You can copy it, paste it, and again paste it, okay? Because we know that there are three different exponentials in our answer. So what we do is, after copy pasting, we just change the limits, because now we know what we have to write. In our minds, we have already decided what or how our sum is going to turn out. So now we just simply change the values. So suppose if I was doing it, writing this during the exam, I will think into exponential e to the power minus integrating from 0 to 7. So as soon as I would say 0 to 7, I would get my cursor here and change the upper limit to 7 from 1. Okay. 0.05 dp. Again, I would just change the number or the force of mortality basically into exponential minus integration of integration from 0 to 2, 0.08 dp. So I will just remove the 0.04 and write a 0.08 instead. Okay, so that is how we go on with such questions. After that, again, as I said, show one level of expansion and then give the final answer. All right, it's not necessary that you have to show the values of each and every thing. Over here, they have also skipped the step of assigning the values or the substitution of x. When you take the variable inside the box bracket, the answer in terms of the variable, and then you substitute the values into the final answer. That step also they haven't given. You all can give it. A reminder, how do we do that? Let's say in the box bracket, you have given let's say that it is something like 0.6. Okay, that is what you have got after solving the integral. Now you have to assign the limit values to your answer. How do you do that? Inside the normal bracket, you write your limits, okay, final limits. All right, so let's say in this case it was 0,1. Okay. So you assign the final limit in the first bracket. Okay. Have you been doing this in the equation editor? All people to enter the equation editor. For giving limits for in the box brackets or in any case, you will always first give the lower limit, and current you will also give the upper limit, and only after that will you press the space bar. Okay, so that both the limits take their places. Okay, so that's part one. Part two is A colleague has suggested that the analyst use the following formula to model the forces of mortality at age x. Mu x is equal to, and this entire formula is given. Verify that the probability that a 65-year-old male is alive at age 75 using the suggested model matches the result calculated in part 1 to 6 decimal places. So, in the first part, we had already calculated the mortality or the probability. Now, using this formula again, we will be doing this. So, all of you must be knowing that this formula represents the model, Meckham's law of mortality. So, what you all can do, of course, now the next step would be to apply the formula, the probability formula for Meckham's law of mortality. So, you have to specify which variable or which parameter is taking what value. Okay, in this question, they have given it very clearly. A plus BC to the power X. So it's very amply clear what is A, what is B, what is C. So you just have to mention Meckham's law of mortality. A is equal to, B is equal to, and C is equal to. Right? After that, we use the formula. So as you can see, they have mentioned, even for the formula, they have mentioned the page number. And that is what we also expect you to do, that if you are using any complicated formula, which you can be unsure of, which you do tend to be unsure of. So you will, obviously, since it's an open book exam, you will want to check it. Just verify it once. So whenever you open your table book to verify it, then please just write the page number where you got the formula for verification. So what happens is, there is no negative marking for giving such references. Of course, it's the table book. You are always allowed to use it during the exams. So what all they are asking out of you is to be completely transparent in whatever you are doing, so that they know that yes, it is a first-hand paper. Everything you have done, you have written, it's all by you. Okay. Again, over here, the underscores are not necessarily required. Okay. Now, again, they have introduced some more variables, S and G. So, to make things simpler, it's always suggested that instead of writing this entire thing in the original equation, you should introduce more variables and just assign them values to make your answers look concise. Otherwise, it gets so complicated that even the examiner, not just the examiner, even you, when you are trying to check your work, you might get a little lost as to where exactly did you make the mistake, or where exactly could have been the mistake. Okay. So again, just an integration solving normal like the previous sum. Over here, see, they have shown the box bracket thing in this case. One thing, they have given the colon. Yes, I would suggest give the colon. But even if you don't, it's fine. Of course, it is just a personal thing. You can always give the colon to be on the safer side. All right. Next question. Yeah, and the last part is a commenting. So in the previous class, I had discussed for commenting, make sure that the first thing that you mention is the answers that you have obtained. All right. The answers that you obtained, you should mention that and make an upper comparison, like a superficial comparison first, and then from the next paragraph you should delve into the details of it. You can obviously, they've inserted a table over here for inserting it. You can go to the insert tab and insert the table for adding rows and columns. Suppose you didn't realize that you will be requiring so many rows, you can always do a right click, and in the insert option, you can insert the columns as well as the rows anywhere you want in your answer script. Next question. Question number 8. An insurance company offering private medical insurance wants to build a machine learning model to predict the expected medical costs of policyholders based on their age and BMI. The data set that will be used to train the model consists of the actual medical costs together with the age and BMI of 9 past policyholders and is set out in the table below. An actuarial suggested using a recursive binary decision tree algorithm as the basis for the model. This involves splitting the space spanned by age and BMI into disjoint region as follows. We've given the details of the node and they have also given a diagram. So one thing you can be rest assured about is in paper A, there is a 0.0001% probability that you will be asked to draw a decision tree. For that matter, any graph or any sort of diagram, it will be more of analyzing, more of interpreting graphs and things, but you will probably not be asked to make any. So it's important that you understand the concept, but you don't have to know how to make these on MS Word. However, for in case, I just want to show you all, in case something like this happens, you can always go to the insert tab and insert shapes. You have the rectangles, you have the arrows, okay? So now the arrow, you will get a plus sign. You can insert the arrow, draw it in any direction you want, whatever size you want, just by clicking on your cursor and dragging around, you can get whatever arrow you want, okay? For changing it, just like any normal picture we do for in any of the applications, we can just drag it around, move it, you can extend it, you can again rotate it however you want, okay? So that's how you insert the arrow, and same for the rectangles as well, all right? Now, part one, derive the formula for least squares estimator of alpha k. Now this question again, it was quite a surprise for the candidates. So, and a lot of new form of typing involved. So let yi over here, this is a case where you can let go of the underscore, okay? An example similar to xij. You can simply write y and i, no need for the underscore. Represent the actual medical cost of the IF policyholder. Then the residual sum of squares in region sk is given by RSS alpha k is equal to sum all I that are members of the set S. So usually what we do is the rule we follow for sum product integration, we write the limits inside the bracket, right? But in such a case where the limits aren't specified, it's more of a class or more of a subjective range, or maybe using words they are writing limits. So what do we do? While writing on paper, what we do is we give the sigma sign and then just at the bottom, we write the variable. Let's say we just write I. It means that all values that I can take, we are summing over that. So in MS Word, what we do is all I, make sure your I doesn't become capital. In case it does, keep your I on it. So you can just press Ctrl Z and it will automatically undo the automation and go to a small I again. All I that are members of set K, set SK, right? This is how we would have read the limits. That's how we will write it as well. And then you write the function which you're summing over normally. Okay. Part two. Determine using the training data set the values of the least squares estimators of alpha k derived in part 1 for each value of k is equal to 1 to 5. So now you just have to do the solving in this one. You make the table. You make the table. You, I think, yes, you have to add one column. So usually you cannot copy paste tables from the PDF. What is suggested is that you make the table from scratch. However, usually we do not suggest that you copy paste the table. It is always better that you type it out, because anyway, if you copy paste it, it will come like this, correct? So it's always better that you rewrite the table again. So as you can see, for the table there are 3 marks. So writing this will only take you some seconds. Some seconds it will take you. However, for making the entire table is the main reason why they have assigned 3 marks to it. All right. Part 3. One more thing in this one. There was the alpha hat thing. So here the hat, you don't have to give the caret sign. You can simply write alpha 1 hat. So how do you write it? You write it like alpha 1. And because the entire thing has a hat over it, you can give a bracket and write hat. Similarly, you can either copy paste it if you want, but however, since it's just 2 words that are going on repeating, I would suggest that it's better only if you type it. It will hardly make any difference. Or if you want to copy it, of course, there is no stopping you. Determine the predicted medical costs for each of the 3 policyholders in the test data using the fitted model in part two. So again, in this question, again, just you have to make the table and you have to give the, you have to add these columns. All right. Part four, the actuary decides to fit a linear regression model to the original training data set to compare the performance of the 2 machine learning models. The linear regression model takes the following form, where EI represents error term for the ith policy holder, beta, everything they've explained. The estimates also they have given. Okay, we have to determine the predicted model costs for each of the 3 policy holders in the test data set using the linear regression model. So all we have to do is just put in the values. So again, we give an expanded version of the equation where you mention and substitute each and every parameter accordingly. Just like this. Here, again, if you want to insert the table, okay, what you can do is you can copy paste this table from your answer script to your answer script. Copy pasting is allowed. So you can copy paste this table, remove these 2 columns, and then insert. You can just remove this column and just change the contents of the last column, right? That is one way of doing it. The other way is, if you do not wish to make the table, you can simply write for policyholder 1 and just write this. The other data is not required because it is already present in the question and once you've already mentioned it in your answer. Comparing again, theoretical only mostly, make sure you mention all the solutions that you have obtained in your question. Last question, time series question, as you can see, always contain a lot of marks because it is an important topic and it also requires a significant amount of typing. So they are usually some of the longest questions in the paper. So determine whether YT is stationary and identify the values of PDQ for which the process in an ARIMA PDQ process. So in such a question, it is very clear cut. First of all, you have to show it how it is stationary. So of course, for that we use the characteristic polynomial. Now the characteristic polynomial, again, make sure you show proper logging for it and give the reason. Don't forget this at all. Don't just write therefore YT is stationary. You must write the answer that why is it stationary? Because both roots are greater than 1 in magnitude. Okay. And then you write ARIMA 200 process. Let rho k and phi k denote the values at lag k of the autocorrelation and partial autocorrelation functions respectively. We have to calculate rho 1, rho 2, rho 3 and then phi 1, phi 2, phi 3. No, very, very common question, very simple question. So you will work your equations. You must give this condition in time series. It's very important for k greater than or equal to 1 and for the other cases. Okay. So make sure you mention this reason every time that you give a conclusion regarding the autocorrelation or partial autocorrelation. Here also, the underscore, yes, I would suggest give it. If not, then you can also just write row 1, row 2, etc. Alright, that is also acceptable. Part 3 is the partial autocorrelation, so it goes in the same way. You write it normally. Again, even in the time series, you can see they've shown proper working. Every single component of the equation or the function has been written separately. Okay, so make sure you also do it in the same way. Part 4, determine minimum sample size n necessary to reject the null hypothesis of a white noise process under the Luckenbach-Portmanteau test using 3 lags and a 5% significance error. Another equation solving question. And now the exams are online, so you can expect a lot of equation solving based questions because now they will concentrate more on the same values, etc. Otherwise, calculations tend to become easier. I mentioned in one of my classes how they had given the Kaplan-Meier or one of the survival questions they had given in September 21 term, how they had modified it to include a missing value, which prevented us from making all the calculations on Excel. Had it not been a missing value question, had they directly asked us for, I think it was a chi-squared test, I think. So the test value or this test statistic could easily be calculated simply by inserting a formula in Excel. So to avoid such things, they concentrate more on missing values. All right. So again, a sum. K is equal to 1 to m. Now, usually this k equal to quotient, we do not write. Why? Because we assume that it is something, it is very understandable that the variable is taking the values. However, in this one, you can see that there is k as well as m, right? So it's always better in such cases to mention which variable we are talking about. Again, a full-fledged line of explanation of the formula or the substitution of values should be shown. Page 169 of the tables, very, very, very important. Every critical value, you must mention the page number and clearly mention the significance level, the parameters, etc., of which the critical value pertains to. After that, it's just the normal equation solving. So as you can see, it's normal equation. You have to form it. Be very careful with the brackets. Okay. Every time you give a caret sign, make sure whatever is to the power of has a bracket. Every time you're giving a division or a fraction form, make sure the entire numerator is in a bracket separately and the entire denominator also is in a bracket separately. Okay. If you're adding such a fraction to something, then I would suggest give a pair of brackets after the numerator and denominator have been put together also. All right. Part 5 is the merits, the relative merits of the test. So that's satisfying. That's something you all can do. Very tricky question, not a very common one. So make sure you go through it. As you can see, most of them are for half marks, the points. So it was a 5-mark question. You will have to give a minimum of 10 points, minimum. Always better to give 12 points at least, because mostly 2 points are just anything we write. We don't consider all the points. So that's that. 5 marks means 12 points. Okay. So I think that's it. Here we complete April 21 paper as well. We will keep another class closer to the exams where you all can discuss doubts, etc. And we can discuss some last moment tips and tricks also. And some things that you must keep in mind while giving the exam. So for today, we'll end here. Thank you, all of you.